Okay, listen, it's such a pleasure right now to welcome onto your Feel Good Breakfast show probably one of the most talented people in all of the world. This gentleman is a performer, he's a singer, he's a songwriter, producer, production maker, storyteller, broadcaster, dancer. You name it, he can do it. And right now he's celebrating 30 years. I'm talking 3 decades in the industry. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, Emo Adams is in the studio!
I want to thank my mother and my father, and also don't forget I was also body double for Bruce Willis in Armageddon.
This is that would have been something for the
kids. No, I was.
My brother?
I was like Keggy, you know, the space suit.
Do that.
How are you doing, buddy?
I'm good, man, and so happy for you, especially at this juncture in your life. 30 years.
Crazy.
Has that kind of sunk in? Do you wake up in the morning and go, oh my gosh? 30 years.
No, the first thing that I still need to deal with is the fact that I've got white kids. That is amazing. So I still can't deal with that, let alone 30 years in the industry. Oh. Do you know what I mean? So when I say, like, who's your daddy, I really mean it. Like, seriously, who's your good taste, buy of it.
Oh, man.
Listen. No, I can't because, you know, I started when I was 9 years old with David Crom and Tully Peterson. And I didn't know that this journey was going to bring me to this amazing place in my life and having this amazing platform as well. So it's lekker, man.
And now you're deciding to celebrate it with inviting everyone who's ever loved your music, your entertainment, the guys from Jag that have been part of your journey to celebrate it with you. How do you do that? How do you encapsulate 30 years into a show and say, cool, this
it's
is...
It's literally impossible, but what you can do is you can give people snippets of the 30 years. And more so, you can invite friends who has some sort of an understanding of what you went through over the 30 years. Yeah. And so there's quite a few surprises. Like, was it a helicopter gekry? Was it the heel eerste mense wat a helicopter kry wat in Grand Western land, maar dis a week later. So nobody will see that.
Show.
Yeah, nobody will see that, but I just wanted to mention that at random.
I love that. And also, so give me some other snippets that people might not be able to see musically on the stage, but that was also big highlights and very relevant to your journey over 30
years. I mean, as I said, I feel very blessed to have made it to 30 years. Yeah. I mean, you know, the day I knew was the day that the late great Nelson Mandela came to our school and I had to sing the Nkosi Sikelel' and it was known as the unofficial anthem back then. But I was nervous because the moment was too big and he had his hand on my shoulder and I just started crying and
You're
I was
kidding.
Like, I know. And I was like, why? why? And so then I knew,
that's
and then
amazing.
Fast forward to about 3 years ago when we were celebrating 20 years of democracy, David Cromer asked myself and my brother Lukman to join him in New York to perform in Carnegie Hall. And these are moments that you can't embodify or showcase on a stage, you know? So we're going to try and screen it for people so that they can share a 30-year journey with us. And I think I brought Jag specifically because they were the biggest part of my 30-year career.
Oh my goodness. Wow, dude, listen, I cannot wait to see the show and I hope that you're getting your tickets as well to go and check out the show. You cried when Nelson Mandela touched your shoulder. That's the
because
manliest thing ever.
It's like a man, the myth. It's a bird, it's a plane. No, it's Madiba. You know what I mean? It's like, but you don't want to cry, but it was like a manly cry. So if that helps, I don't know if it does.
All of us would have done it. Listen, stay tuned. After the break, this man, that stage, they're becoming the same WhatsApp group.
It's
performing,
it's
Baba.
Coming.
In the same
it's
WhatsApp
becoming.
Group.
It's becoming.